There were no comedy clubs in the 60s, and there were just folk music clubs. And that was really the foundation, I think, for the comedy clubs.
Nightclubs were starting to go out of business as the sort of trajectory of America changed. Hippies were taking over. They were more interested in just dancing to records as opposed to going and seeing a stage show, you know, where there was a supper club entertainment and an orchestra and you had to pay for dinner.
I met Gary at Leadbetter's, and there was a guy who owned it named Randy Sparks. He had the New Christy Minstrels, which was the big band, and I think that was so successful. I think there were like 12 performers on stage. And so, you know, you create another one and create another one. And there was these very good folk music groups, the Back Porch Majority and the New Society. They did great, funny comedy and banter between them. And looking back, he was so generous to everyone.
This is where John Duchendorf was the MC, who later became John Denver. Steve Martin was the magician. The Carpenters were 12 years old and had to sit out with their mother in the alley between sets whenever they played there because there was beer being served. And then Michael Nesmith had a group there, who later was in the Monkees. So I'm thrown right in the middle of all this stuff. Danny Whalen, the manager, came over and said, you can check IDs at the door, you got a job tonight. So I checked IDs and he said, by the way, Michael Martin Murphy and Owens Castleman are leaving the New Society and we're gonna be doing auditions tonight. Randy Sparks was sitting back on his throne at Leadbetter's. I didn't really know what I was going to do, but I thought I better do something. Why I did this, I'll never know. But I said, I'm from South Dakota. I'm kind of new out here, and I was out in the alley and I saw something weird. A guy and a girl got in an argument. A guy tried to pick up this girl and she stabbed him in the hand with a fingernail file. Just at that time, I took my hand out of my pocket and I had it wrapped in a handkerchief, like it was me that got stabbed, and I started into my song. And for some reason, that made Randy Sparks really laugh. I didn't even have to sing a song. He just says, okay, stop. Tell me your name again. He says, for right now, you're in the New Society. So we had what was called the LA Wrecking Crew doing our album, which was like Carol Kaye on bass, Jim Keltner on drums, Glenn Campbell doing guitars, Jack Nitzsche and his orchestra were part of it, and we did this beautiful record. It's called the Baroque Sounds of the New Society. It was a combination of Baroque music and rock. So here I am, 2 days in Southern California. I'm in a group that's already on RCA Victor Records that's going to be on the Jack Linkletter show in a very short time on national television. And I haven't a clue what I'm doing, but I'm in show business.